Genau. I'd like to show you how to form the intersection of these two deterministic finite automata. And in this video I want to be more detailed and I will use the transition tables for this. So here you have one automaton with its transition table, and here's the other one with its transition table. And what does the intersection mean? That means that we want to create a new automaton that consists of all transitions that are present in both automata. And what is, that's the first problem, because, well, in both automata we have an initial state, but the states itself can have different names. Here they are. It's a coincidence that they have the same names from Q0 to Q2, but they could be named totally different. But this doesn't matter. Here will be the transition table of our new automaton. And the states in this new automaton will consist of the cross product of both of the states in this initial automaton. So let's take this state, which is named Q0, Q0. It represents that we are in state Q0 in the first automaton, and that we are in Q0 in the second automaton. So it doesn't matter what their names are, you just combine every state from one automaton with every state in the other. Now, how to retrieve the transitions from it? Well, this transition table, it means if you are in Q0 and you read an A, you can make a transition to Q1. That's like this transition here in the graph. So in the left automaton, you with an A, you would go to Q1. So here I write Q1. And in the second automaton, if we are in Q0 and you read an A, you stay in Q0. So this is equivalent to a transition in the new automaton to Q1, Q0, because in the first automaton we would move to Q1 and in the second we would stay in Q0, and this is represented in the new automaton by the state Q1, Q0. And that's how we will fill out the whole transition table. I can do it a little bit quicker because, well, here we always start in Q0 and reading an A, so it's everything the same regarding this, because we will always move into Q1 in the left automaton. Then here from Q1 with an A in the left automaton, we will move to A. So I can quickly fill out in Q1 with an A, we move to Q2. So I can quickly fill this out. Then from Q2 in the left automaton with an A, we also go to Q2. So Q2. Q2, Q2, and then we are having a look at the right automaton. Here with Q0, when we read an A, we go to Q0, so now we have to, they change here, so here we are in Q0 in the right automaton, so I write down Q0 here, and here. And then I will have to look for the other states. Here we are in the right automaton in Q1, reading an A, staying in Q1, Q1, Q1. Then with Q2, when we are reading an A, we stay in Q2, Q2, Q2. then we have to fill out the same for B. So if we are in the left automaton in Q0 and we read a B, we move to Q0, so it's Q0 here and here and here. Then in Q1 with the B, we stay in Q1. Q1, it's always Q1 here. Then when we are in Q2 with a B, we stay in Q2. It was for the left automaton, not for the right one. If we are in Q0 and we read a B, we move to Q1. My writing is so bad. Then from Q1 to with a B, we move to Q2. But I think you get the main idea how this works. So from Q2 with a B, we move to Q2. Q2. And now we have the transition table for our new automaton. And I already drew them in another video, so I will just make it very quick here, because we didn't talk about initial and final states yet. So the automaton looked something like this, with this 9 new states. So what is the initial state? And in the new automaton, the initial state will be the one that's the initial state in both of the automatons. So in this one, Q0 is the initial state, and in this one, 2. So in this automaton, this state Q0, which represents a state where we are in the initial state in both automatons, this is also the initial state in our new automaton. So it will be this one. So Q0 is this one. Yeah, sorry for my writing, but I think you get the idea. Now the final state in our new automaton, the final state will be the one that is the final state in both of the automaton. So here's the final state Q1. Here's the final state Q1. And this is equivalent to this state where we are in the final state in both automatons. So if I remember correctly, it was this one. So you can see the whole automaton in another video. And in this one, my aim was to show you how it's constructed with the transition table. And I hoped it helps you.